You get bitch?
Yeah.
Hey, you get somebody, bitch?
Somebody's got to do it, right? Everyone good?
I'm rolling.
All right, Harry, I think it's been 5 years since you've been in the winner's circle. How good is it to be back and do it here?
Yeah, it feels great. Winning is very difficult. Golf is a stupid game. But to do it here is very, very sweet, especially 5 years ago, roughly probably to the day, I fell just a shot short. So it was very nice. I mean, I had some very, very fortunate things happen there towards the end, but thrilled to get it done here.
Can you talk a little bit about the support that you felt every single day?
Yeah, it was pretty awesome. I tried my best to soak it all in, but I really got into a good place today where I was just, honestly, boring stuff, focusing on my breath and trying to keep my heart rate down and trying not to get too excited seeing all these folks that I know and love. And I did a great job of that. And then it was nice to finish it off and then kind of let some of it out. I just kind of like freak out there for a little bit. But the support was second to none. All these folks here, they've watched me grow up, and it's nice to give them a moment where somebody that they hopefully, well, they definitely know and hopefully love, watch somebody like that achieve one of their goals.
Obviously, finishing a playoff, but can you talk us through that, your last shot in regulation?
Yeah. I had a horrible lie, and I was trying to land it, I think, about 15 yards further onto the green than it actually did. With it being a bad lie, obviously it was going to come out with quite a bit of topspin, and I didn't think I hit it hard enough to land it on the green. I don't even know where it landed, but it came out with topspin, and once it landed, it was rolling quick, so I figured it was going to be up there, probably within 10, 12 feet of the hole. And then the roars got louder and louder and louder, and we were already walking ahead. I was thinking, why are they screaming? Why? There's no way. And then I guess it dropped, and they freaked out, and then I also freaked out. So I had to get back into the breathing and control my heart rate, trying not to freak out too much. Signed my card, hit a few balls, and then I was fortunate it broke my way that I'd have a chance in a playoff for sure. Tanner, who I just met, played some unbelievable golf with a two-shot lead to do what he did today. Takes a lot of mettle for somebody that Monday qualified into the event, so all credit to him. But I felt like I probably should have apologized to him before we teed off. But that's just it. Golf's hard. Winning's hard. Stupid stuff happens. I was just lucky that the stupid stuff happened to me.
It's been hard the last 2 years. I mean,
yeah.
I kind of peaked like 3 years ago, obviously, PGA Championship week. Is this like you're starting to see? Like, because there are rounds you'll have, but not probably the tournament results you want.
Yeah.
Is this a sign like, okay, I do see?
I'd say so. I had a goal of just kind of controlling the few things that you actually can control while you're out playing, competing in a golf tournament. And I would say I did that relatively well, but I still had moments where I got frustrated. I drove the ball. I've been driving the ball really well, so I drove the ball great. But my iron play has been what has held me back. And I just tried my best to have like a clear intent and then a rehearsal to match what I had pictured and go from there. And then trying my best to accept when it didn't end up as I thought it would, which I'm still not great at. But I definitely did that, and I didn't get in my own way as I've been doing before. And I only shot one under the first day from the middle of every freaking fairway, and it was driving me nuts. But I stayed patient. At one point, I parred every hole in the back nine on Thursday, and then I parred the first eight holes on this nine, starting on 10 on Friday. I was about to lose my mind, 17 pars in a row. Fortunate to make a birdie here, and then went on a little bit of a run. And then the last 2 days, I just tried to focus on it even more and more. Clear intent, rehearsal to match, go. I have it written down. I'm probably going to write it down on a few more things and really try to focus on that, because clearly what I do is good enough. I just need to make sure I can take care of the stuff that I can control.
I know this isn't the path you probably thought it was going to be after getting car, but are you enjoying this kind of journey and kind of discovering
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it's not always fun. But I think I've said it probably four times. Golf is hard, and it's difficult for me, who has played at a, no disrespect, but a higher level than this, to be knocked down But it's okay to be humbled. And, you know, I was certainly humbled, and I needed to, and I'm still going to need to do it. I have not dealt with success well in the past. I've gotten maybe complacent and just thought, well, I've been hitting good shots, I'm just going to keep doing that. No, I was hitting good shots for a reason. So I need to make sure that I focus on those things that I have focused on, you know, this week. And then also, it's okay if it doesn't work out as I wish, you know, take a freaking deep breath and move on. So I think I've got a nice little plan, and I'm really looking forward to wherever it may be this year, working that plan and seeing it how it stacks up, right? And it's okay to be humbled. I'm cool however this path goes. But I have some things I want to achieve in this game, and the result, which doesn't really matter, but it's nice to get, the result that I got certainly makes it easier on the path to working to achieve what I want to achieve.
And what is the path going to be for the rest of the summer?
My goal was, we got married 2 weeks ago, my goal was to play great golf for 2 or 3 weeks on either this tour or the big tour, and then tell everybody to, you know what, off, and I'm going to go take a honeymoon. So this is a good start. Maybe I'll go another 3 or 4 weeks if I can get a nice result again, then I'm out. I don't think I'll really wind up getting in many PGA Tour events, really between now and probably after the U.S. Open, I'd guess. So that will, maybe it'll lighten up a bit. So I'm planning on playing this tour, and hopefully, you know, also now I know Tim has won twice, and I'm still probably way behind him, but if you can wind up winning the money list out here, there's a huge carrot at the end of that. So maybe sit and focus, maybe alter my goals a little bit, maybe alter my plans to play here more. But certainly from now until, I don't know, mid-June, I plan on being out here, unless we get going real good another couple weeks and I'm out.
Was the chip in the playoff, was that easy on a Tuesday, but obviously the situation, or what was that?
It wasn't that hard. You kind of just chop down on it and get it to roll. Now, to get it, I didn't want it to land over this first slope. And I've actually struggled with that shot. I'm catching them too far out on the toe, so they come out dead and fly shorter. And I worked on that a little bit just over on the practice green. I still towed that a little bit, but I think it came out nice and flew a little further. On a Tuesday, that shot's pretty easy. And then an hour ago, it's a little bit more difficult. But I did a good job taking a deep breath, picturing how I wanted to hit it. And it came out pretty much exactly how I thought it should have, and then was fortunate to – I didn't hit a great putt. I was fortunate that putt caught the right edge, and we were done.
Harry, to win on a home course like this, in front of your Blue Mountain North guys,
yeah.
Obviously with everything going on in your life, it's got to mean a little bit more knowing that it's right here.
For sure. I am not usually one that – would be at a loss for words or have a hard time describing how I feel or what goes on, but it is relatively difficult to describe how awesome this is to win here. I think as the night goes on, to see the excitement and the enjoyment on others' faces, that will get it to the point where I will have realized, like, this is really, really cool. For me, kind of right now, it's just I won a golf tournament. Awesome. I checked a lot of boxes. I did a lot of things that I wanted to do this week. It was fortunate that I obviously got a great result. But as the celebrations go and I see the excitement on people's faces, and the excitement I've already seen, that truly means the world to me. It's really cool. These are people, I mean, we've been here for 20 plus years. These are people that have seen me grow up, seen me make mistakes, seen me be an idiot, which I still probably am. But to do this with all of them here is really, really cool. The best in a moment like that, yeah, for sure. I've had some weird stuff happen to me in golf where you kind of don't really plan on any, you know, something great happening, and then all of a sudden it does. The lie I had was pretty poor, so I was just happy. I just wanted to try to get it in that section and see if I could knock it in, and maybe, you know, a couple bogeys late for it to go in the hole was obviously just dumb luck, and the stars aligned. It was certainly one of the best of my career. I've had some pretty unbelievable weird things happen to me. But in that moment, for that to go in, I'd probably say it was the best of my career for sure.
All right. Thanks, Harry.
God, I could be here all night.
That was great.